All right, now moving with the next topic. Very important topic, because this topic helps to solve difficult questions also, which is cross multiplication method. Cross multiplication method is a formula, but usually I don't used to do with formula. Without the help of formula also you can solve. Now first of all, there's a rule: cross multiplication method is always, or we can say only possible if it is a unique solution. It means a1 upon a2 not equal to b1 upon b2. If this is equal, if this is the condition, then only cross multiplication method can work. Okay, a1 upon a2 not equal to b1 upon b2, then only this method is applicable. So if it is a unique solution, then only we can try this method. Okay, so cross multiplication method, we will do an example. Let's say the first question, I'll take an equation from textbook itself. If it is x plus y equal to 2, and I'm taking on my own, 2x plus 3y equal to 6. Now this is the question. Now if you observe, a1 upon a2, 1 upon 2, if in rough you check, 1 upon 2 is not equal to 1 upon 3. The coefficient of x is 1 upon 2 and coefficient of y is 1 upon 3. Both are not equal. So if the coefficient are not equal, then we can use this method. Now first thing is, first you have to write the equation in equal to 0 form. Whenever you have this method, write in equal to 0 form, and in the form of ax plus by plus c equal to 0. This also, 2x plus 3y minus 6 is equal to 0. Every time, whenever you're doing cross multiplication method, this way you will do every time. First write the equation in equal to 0 form, and in general form, ax plus by plus c equal to 0 form. It should be in this form, and then start the sum. Now this is a rough work. Before I start the sum, I will show the rough work. First x, x coefficient is what? It is 1 and 2. What is y coefficient? 1 and 3. And constant coefficient is minus 2 and minus 6. Okay, and again I'll write x at the last. I'll tell you why. X coefficient again 1 and 2. Okay, now how to make the formula? Now this is the main sum. This was the rough work. This is the rough work. Okay, and now this is the main sum equal to y equal to 1. Now x, for writing x, or writing the numbers, or we know the how to write here, what will be written here. So how you will do it? Hide the coefficient of x. What you observe, as you hide the coefficient of x, you observe this two. Okay, you will do cross multiplication from left to right. Left to right, 1 into minus 6. So hide this 1 into minus 6 and this. Always this is the rule. Okay, left to right and here. So 1 into minus 6 minus 2 into 3. Minus 2 into 3. Simple. 1 into minus 6 minus, then again multiply, 2 minus 2 into 3. Again for y, see, again as for x we have two terms behind, so for y also we need two terms. It was only one term, so I have written x again behind. So again this sequence will be maintained. That's why I am writing x now. So y again from here to here, minus 2 into 2, minus 2 into 2, minus 1 into minus 6. Again cross multiply, 1 into minus 6. And similarly for 1 also, hide 1, again from left to right, 1 into 3. If you are missing the sequence, you'll get wrong answer in negative and get an answer in negative also. So 1 into 3 minus 1 into 2. So this way the multiplication is done. First is, first hide for x, you hide x, 1 into minus 6 minus 2 into 3, hide y, multiply minus 1 into minus 6. Again for 1, 1 into 3 minus 1 into 2. So this way the formula will be done. So now solve it. X upon, this is minus 6 and this is minus plus minus. Now if you observe, this is if you solve, I've taken an example, that's why I'm getting answer here 0, but in normal sim not get 0 here. So here I'm again, what I'm getting here, I'm getting a plus 6, but in the actual sum you not get 0 over here. So this is an example just to understand. Minus 4 plus 6 and here 1 upon 3 minus 2. So I'm getting x upon 0, y upon 2 and 1 upon 1. Okay, x upon 0, y upon 2 and 1 upon 1. So what to do now? Our last step is write this equal to this and write this also equal to this. It means x upon 0 will be equal to 1 upon 1 and y upon 2 will be equal to 1 upon 1. It means simply you have to write this equal to last term and y also equal to last term. Means x upon 0 equal to 1 upon 1. So what you will get, x is equal to cross multiply 0 upon 1 and y is equal to 2 upon 1. So x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 2. If you observe x equal to 0 and y is equal to 2 is the solution. Put the value and cross check. Y is 0, x is 0 and 2. It is right. Okay. I think one example is not enough. I will take one more question. Let us say a question which is there you have solved. This is the easy form. I will take an example from here. Let me take an example which is 3x plus 4y equal to minus 6 and 3x minus y equal to 9. Now this example will help you a lot. Now concentrate properly. Question is 3x plus 4y is equal to minus 6. Okay. And 3x minus y is equal to 9. I have taken an example. What is the first rule? Write the equation in equal to 0 form. 3x plus 4y. 3x plus 4y plus 6 will be equal to 0. And here 3x minus y minus 9 equal to 0. Writing equal to 0 form. 3x plus 4y minus 6 will come plus 6 equal to 0. And this is 3x minus y minus plus will come here minus 9 equal to 0. Is it a unique solution? Is it a1 upon a2 not equal to b1 upon b2? Check. 3 upon 3 not equal to 4 upon minus 1. So it is a unique solution. This means cross multiplication method exists. You can write it over here, but I'm not writing now. In exam, you can explain that the unique solution is there, so we can use cross multiple method. Now this is rough work. Understand, this is rough part. In exam, you can do it in rough part. Okay, x, what is the coefficient of x? 3 and 3. Coefficient of y? 4 and minus 1. What is the coefficient of x? 3 and 3. Coefficient of y? 4 and minus 1. Nothing means next to y, nothing means 1. Minus 1. And constant means 1. That's why important. Equal to write equal to 0. The sign will change. 1 is 6 and minus 9. So this is the first step. First step equal to 0 form. And next step is to write the coefficient just below the number. X coefficient, y coefficient and constant coefficient. Okay. Now how to make the formula. X. Now again understand x. Again you write double time. X 3 3. Because you want to make formula. For x what to do? Hide x. From left to right, 4 into minus 9, 4 into minus 9, multiply, then minus, again multiply, 6 into minus 1. This is the simple rule. If you follow, there will be no problem. Again, for y, if you want to find y, hide y, again from left to right, 6 into 3, again minus, again multiply, 3 into minus 9. Okay, and similarly for 1, hide 1, 3 into minus 1, minus, again multiply, 4 into 3. So I believe you have understood the concept, very simple concept, hide x, multiply, minus, again multiply, y hide, multiply, minus, again multiply, for 1, multiply, again minus, and again multiply. Simple rule, with the help of this you can easily solve, now solve it, what you are getting, x, 4, 9, the 36, here plus 6, y upon 18 plus 9 is 27 because minus minus plus and here minus 3 and here minus 3 4 is 12. So here I am getting x is equal to x upon minus 30, y upon 37, 47, 45 and then 1 upon minus 15. Okay, so I am getting this answer. So now what to do? This equal to this, x upon minus 30 equal to minus is equal to minus 1 upon 50. And y upon 45 is equal to minus is equal to 1 upon minus 15. So what to do? First equal to last term and second also equal to last term to get the answer. So what you will get? X equal to 2 and y is equal to minus 3. If you solve, x upon minus 30 is equal to 1 upon minus 15 and y upon 45 is equal to 1 upon minus 15. check if you want to solve this, cross multiply minus 30 upon 15 minus 15 and y upon y is equal to 45 upon minus 15. So 15 1 the 15 2 the minus minus plus, so x equal to 2 and your y is equal to 15 1 the 15 3 the y is equal to 3. So this is what the cross multiplication method is. Now important part is, as you solve this type of question, it will be easy to solve difficult question also. So I will be discussing now the optional question, because in optional exercise all difficult questions are there. So same type question I will discuss, because cross multiplication method is helpful in that question. So let us do this exercise 3.7, question number 7. Question is px plus qy equal to p minus q and qx minus py equal to p plus q. Okay, if you observe, the question is in very complicated form. So whenever you observe a complicated question, always try to use cross multiplication method, because it helps to solve easy. What is the first rule of cross multiplication method? Write in equal to zero form. So how to write px plus qy, px plus qy, and now sign will change, minus p and minus q become plus q equal to 0, correct? And similar this also, qx minus py, this will become minus p and minus q equal to 0, simple. And now what is the second step? This was the first step. Second step is write the coefficient. X coefficient is what? P and q, and obviously it is a unique solution, because a1 upon a2 and b1 upon b2 is not equal. Okay, x is p upon p and q, y coefficient is q and minus p. Check, x coefficient is p and q, y coefficient is q and minus p, and constant, because this was y, constant means whatever left is constant. Constant is minus p plus q, and here it is minus p minus q, because this is first part, second part, and this is the constant. Okay, so x coefficient, y coefficient, and the constant one. This is rough work, again I'm telling, don't show in exam. You can show in bracket, that will be fine, but this is rough work. Now actual formula will be this way, x. How to make formula? Again, x you write again behind, right? So now how to make formula of x? Hide x, cross multiply from left to right, q into this, q into minus p minus q, multiply, simply multiply, simply multiply, minus this also multiply, minus p minus p plus q. Okay, then y also same rule, simply multiply, minus p plus q into q, minus this also multiply, p into minus p minus q. Okay, two done. So two things done. Now number one is left, the space is less, I'm doing down, equal to one. Now for one, hide this, simply multiply p into minus p and q minus q into q. Formula is what? Multiply, then put minus and again multiply. Simple. Okay, first arrange in proper order and then no problem will come in this. Now first part I will solve this, x upon, now this was how much? Q into minus q, my q into minus p minus p q, q you have to multiply q, q into minus q minus q square. Now solve bracket first, so minus as it is, I'll solve the bracket. So minus p plus p square, and here minus p q, not p square, was minus p minus plus minus p q. Okay, this part solve, equal to y, here is minus p into q minus pq plus q square minus minus minus, like if I open the bracket, okay, if I open the bracket it will come minus p, and so I will solve the bracket first, whatever is comfortable, p into minus p minus p square, p into minus q minus pq. See, p into minus p square and p into minus q minus pq. Now we will open the bracket, x minus pq minus q square minus p square minus minus plus pq equal to, and also the last one I forgot, 1 upon, that will be same, 1 upon p square minus q square, I just forgot to write it, it is, or else I will write it over here, 1 upon minus p square minus q square. Okay, simply multiplied first this. I have solved this point minus p minus p square and minus q square. Now I will solve this part, which is x upon, first I will copy this, x upon minus pq minus q square minus p square minus pq is equal to y upon minus pq plus q square minus p minus p square minus pq and 1 upon minus p square minus q square. I have simply copied it, then I now will solve it. I have not solved anything, I have just copied the same step. X upon, if I open the bracket, minus pq minus q square minus p square minus minus plus pq. Here y upon, only solving part is difficult, otherwise the sum is easy. Simply we are solving, I am not doing anything difficult. Minus minus plus plus p square minus minus plus plus pq is equal to 1 upon minus p square minus q square. Okay, now if I solve this, minus pq plus pq cut, minus pq plus pq cut, so I will get 1 upon, if I take minus common, 1 upon q square plus p square. I have just taken minus n comma. If you don't want to take, don't take it, no problem. In here, q square plus p square. In here, if you take minus n comma, here also minus p square plus q square. Okay, so now this equal to this and this also equal to this. So x, this is x. X is equal to, or I'll write x is equal to minus q square plus p square is equal to 1 upon minus p square plus q square. In the last one, and y upon q square plus p square is equal to 1 upon minus p square plus q square. Okay, now this equal to this, this both will cut. I can cut it directly also, or else store the method minus q square plus p square upon minus p square plus q square. It will cut, minus minus plus, so x equal to plus 1. And here also this both will get cut. Both will get cut, or show the method y is equal to q square plus p square upon minus this will get cut, so x, y is equal to plus minus minus, so y is equal to minus 1. So this is the answer, x is 1 and y is also minus 1. Okay, you can verify x, put x as 1, y as minus 1, in this x as 1 and y as minus 1, p minus q, hence it is verified. It means your method and sum is correct. See, this is the way you have to solve. Similarly, there are other question also in your, in the exercise. Second question is there, third question is there. There are different type of question. All we have to do same method. Simply by using this method, you can easily solve it and get the answer. Okay. So try and solve the second question, third question. Okay. Second and third question is of the same type. Try and solve it. If you have doubts, ask me. Okay. Second and third are the same type, and fourth is little different. So I will do the fourth one. Okay. Fourth one, if you will check, a minus bx, all these are a Hodge question, which is little difficult. Only solving part is difficult. A square minus 2ab minus b square. This is the question, a minus bx plus a plus dy is equal to a square minus 2ab minus b square. And here it is a plus b x plus y is equal to a square plus b square. Now this is all, this equation is already in the form of ax plus by plus c equal to c equal to 0. This is not in the form. So first I will convert this in equal to 0 form. How to convert? A into x, or a into x plus y plus b into x plus y. If I am doing very fundamental, I am not doing direct. First term into whole term and second term into whole term. Okay, a into whole term and b also into whole term. So multiply ax plus ay plus bx plus by equal to a square plus b square. Now arrange x together, ax plus bx plus ay plus by is equal to a square plus b square. So if I take x common, a plus b x plus, and here y common, a plus b y equal to a square plus b square. If you observe, I got the equation also. This is also x, y and number. This also x, y and number. But if you observe in this question, if you do elimination method, it will be easy because this is also a plus by, this also a plus by, both will get eliminated and you can get x. So I will write this a minus b x plus a plus b y equal to a square minus 2ab minus b square. In this sum I will do elimination because I am able to observe the coefficient of y is equal. See, it is here also a plus by and here also a plus by. So easily elimination can help to at least eliminate one variable. So if you observe, this will not eliminate. What will be this? If you solve this, a minus b minus a. So if you are going to check, this a minus b, sign will change. So minus a and here minus b. So what will come? A and a will get cut. So here will be how much? How much? Minus 2b. Minus 2b and x. X outside only. I am solving only inside part. A minus b. Minus a minus b, because sign will change, is minus is there. So a and a cut, minus 2b and x, here both are same, it will cut equal to, if you check here also, it is a square minus 2ab minus b square minus a square minus b square, the sign will change of this. So a square and a square will cut, minus b square minus b will be minus 2b square. Now here minus 2ab and minus 2b square. Okay, now what do you observe? If you observe 2b is common, dividing by 2b everywhere, if I observe 2b is common, 2b here, so 2b, 2b. If you take divide by 2b everywhere, 2b, 2b and 2b, divide, you can write over here, dividing by 2b, so 2b, 2b cut, this 2b also, this will cut, this also. So what I got? Minus x is equal to minus a. Because 2b cut and minus here 1 2b and here b it will cut. So x is what? If you multiply by an x is what? A plus b. X is a plus b, it is coming. Let me check. 3.7 fourth question. Okay, it is correct. So x is a plus b is the answer. X is equal to a plus b, it is correct. Now x is equal to a plus b, you what? Putting the x is equal to a plus b in any equation, you can do substitution method. X is equal to a plus b, you can put in this equation or in this equation. Both are the difficult type. You can put in this a plus b, x is a plus b over here. So x is equal to, if I put value of ax is a plus b, x is a plus b. So into again a plus b plus a plus b y is equal to a square plus b square. You can substitute in any equation. I have substituted over here a plus b, x is a plus b, so plus a plus b into y, a square plus a square plus b square. Now if you solve this, you will get the answer of y also. So what will be a plus b? A plus b, it is a plus b whole square. If I do directly, a plus coming two times, it means a plus b whole square. A plus b whole square means a square plus 2ab plus b square. And a plus b y is equal to a square plus b square. So a square and b square and a square and b square will cut, because as it will, as this will shift there, this will get cut. So 2ab plus a plus b y equal to 0. So if you solve this, only solving part is remaining. 2ab plus a plus b y is equal to 0. 2a plus b plus a plus b y equal to 0. So I just copy it from there. So a plus b y is equal to minus 2ab. So if I open or this is a multiply, I will divide. Y is equal to minus 2ab upon a plus b. This will be the answer. Let me check. Okay, it is correct. So this is the correct answer. So you see how we have solved. I've used here elimination method because I observed the question was easy to eliminate. Okay, and now one more type of question is there in this. It is what, the last type, which is, we can say it is a method by adding and subtracting you can get answer. This is the fifth question. Minus 378y is equal to minus 74 and minus 378x plus 152y is equal to minus 604. Okay, whenever, as you observe, this type of question will be difficult in any method. If you do elimination, cross multiplication or substitution, it will be very difficult. So whenever you observe very big numbers like this, you will do a method which is say we just add the number, add the equation and subtract the equation. What is the first step? Step 1, add and step 2 subtract. So first I'll add the equation. So addition, what will be 378 and 152, how much? 6 226. If I add both the equation, minus 226x minus 226y, just I'm adding this. So plus minus minus sign of the bigger number, plus minus minus sign of the bigger number, minus 226y minus, this will be 678, I believe. Yes, 678. Okay, 678. And if you observe, it is divisible by 226. Let us check. 268 and 226. 226 threes are 6 is the 18, 3 to the 6, 7, 3 to the 6, 7. Okay, so 3 to the 6, sorry, 6, 226 threes are 226 threes. If I divide by 3, everything by 3, so it will come what? Sorry, I divide by 226. If I divide by 226, if I divide the equation by 226, it will cut, this also will cut, and this 26 1 and 226 threes are. So I will get minus x minus y equal to minus 3, multiplying by minus, so x plus y equal to plus 3. So by adding, I got one equation. Similarly, by subtracting, I will get one more equation. If I subtract this equation, so what will I get? 152x minus 378y is equal to minus 74 minus 378x plus 152y is equal to minus 604. Now I have to subtract. Subtract means sign will change. So here plus, here minus, and here plus. Now how much? 378 plus 152. 10, 1, 8, 12, 13, 4, 4, 5, 530. Okay, it is coming 530x. Okay, and here minus 530y. And here, but here you have to subtract. So 604 minus 74. So 44 cut. So how much? 53. Okay, 53. Yes. Okay, 530. 538 is only coming. So good. All a multiple of 530. Dividing by 530, so we'll get x minus y is equal to 1. Okay. If I divide by 530, x minus y is equal to 1. So I got two equations. X plus y is equal to 3 and x minus y is equal to 1. So I believe now it is very easy to solve. X plus y is equal to 3 and x minus y equal to 1. With the help of elimination method, you can solve, or we can simply add it, 2x y by cut, and here adding, I'm adding, okay. So 4, x is equal to 4 upon 2 means 2, putting the x value over here, okay. So x plus y equal to 3, x is 2, 2 plus y equal to 3, so y is equal to 3 minus 2, 1. So I got x and y is equal to 1, x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 1. So this is one more method. So I believe you understood. Now you have a few questions. Try it. Do with the same method. Again, watch the video if you have doubts. Alright. Thank you.